Hello everyone, this is 22nd June 2014 and I am Madhusudan Raj here again to discuss two more important events that took place in last couple of weeks in India. First thing which I want to discuss today with you is this inflation number which came out, WPI. And after that, the major uproar which is going on right now regarding this hike in the railway fares by the Modi government. So we will first discuss inflation data, who is responsible inflation, why prices are rising, when the price rises inflation, and then we'll talk about whether there was any need for rising or hiking the price of the fare of the railways passenger as well as the freight fare. Because you know this is important to understand because there are a lot of lots of misconception amongst the populace regarding both of these things, especially when the government is trying to blame other parties when the blame is squarely on them itself. So let us first talk about this inflation and what government's response, Modi government's response is to this inflation number. In May the WPI jumped from 5.20 in April to 6.01%, mainly because of potato and tomato and onion vegetable prices. So that was kind of a bit of a shocker because Modi, Mr. Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India, he was in his election campaign, he was kind of presenting himself as a crusader against inflation, and when this number came up, I think his government is in power now since last 2 months, so that was quite of a surprise for everyone. And immediately the finance minister Jaitley and the prime minister and other of his minister immediately started putting blame on other people that why this price are rising. Immediately, what they said is that it's because of the speculative hoarders. Speculative hoarders are responsible for these higher prices of food items and other items. So instead of going into the root of the problem, they immediately said all the governments have the same excuses. If you remember, the same excuse and the same reason was also given by the former finance minister P. Chidambaram. He was also blaming the speculative hoarders for price rise. First thing we have to understand is there is nothing different in between the UPA government and the NDA government. The UPA government finance minister was also blaming speculative hoarders, and the NDA government finance minister is also blaming the same speculative hoarders. I told you in my last blog, last video, economic analysis, that these governments are not going to be any different. They all are pretty much same. They all follow the same economic Keynesian policies. They all will blame other parties for their own mischiefs. What I want to discuss today is that whether speculative hoarders, they are really responsible for the price rise, as government and other people are kind of alleging. What we have to understand over here is, first of all, the answer is absolutely no, they are not responsible for this price rise. And we will see that, in fact, what speculative hoarders do is that they level out the prices, they kind of smooth out the fluctuation in the prices. Right now, what is happening is that there is a kind of a threat. See, what speculative hoarders do, what their role is in the economy. Of course, they all are trying to, earn their profit, but they are trying to earn their profit in an honest way, right? We all are trying to kind of earn profit, we all are, following our self-interest. But as Adam Smith said, this self-interest invisible hand will ultimately result into social welfare of all of us. So the same thing is happening in the case of speculative hoarders. Also, when they are trying to follow their own self-interest, what they are actually indirectly doing is they're helping the society also by, first thing, as I said, by leveling off this very big fluctuation in the prices. They level off this price fluctuations. And second thing is that, as you will see, they provide the very, very precious supply of all these goods and services when they're actually really needed in future. See, one thing is that right now what is happening is that this year the monsoon is likely to be pretty, you know, bad. That's what the forecasts are saying. That's what the Meteorological Department of India, the weather services are saying, that because of the El Nino effect, monsoon is going to be a bit, you know, kind of jittery and kind of uneven. And that's why what is happening is all the speculative hoarders, they are thinking that in future, the supply of all these food items are going to be scarce. So what, see, basically what is speculative activity? Basically buying low and selling high. So what they're doing, and there's nothing wrong with that. We all will, you know, we all try to do that. We all try to buy low and we all try to sell high. As I said, we all are kind of following our own self, you know, subjective profit motive. So there is nothing wrong in being, you know, kind of seeking profit, nothing wrong in being, you know, following your own self-interest. We all do that. But as I said, what they're thinking is that when the right now when the supply is a little bit abundant and the prices are a bit, you know, bit low, what they're doing is they're buying these products at low prices and then storing it for future when they are thinking that in future, because probably monsoon is not going to be strong this year, supply will be very scarce. At that time when supply will be scarce, they will try to sell these products for higher prices, you know, higher prices compared to the low prices at which they are buying these products in present time. So by doing this thing, they are going to gain, or they are, you know, trying, expecting to earn profit. But as I said, there is nothing wrong with this thing. In fact, what happens is that when right now, suppose the supply is very high, prices are very low, maybe that's hurting the farmers. When the speculators go and buy these items from the market and, you know, kind of, you know, stock them, hoard them, what they do is that they increase the prices of this product in present time. So that helps those farmers a little bit, because the prices which are suppressed right now, they goes up. And what they will do, so that, you know, the lower prices is, you know, going up a bit, that is helping the farmers. And what they will do is that, and right now, because, and when see people, other people will see these speculative hoarders stocking up, people will also realize that maybe the future is not going to be good enough. So they will also start to save their resources. They will also start to stock up. And that is good, because suppose in future we are going to have famine, then we will need this food supply in future. Right now it is, you know, quite abundant, so why not save it? Save it right now, and when we'll really need it in future, we use it. So that's what other people will also do. So what is happening, and suppose that in future, if the speculators are right, then what will happen at that time, because of, you know, lack of rain and bad monsoon season and other reasons, when the stock, the supply of these essential items will be really low, at that time these hoarders will bring this supply of these, you know, these items which they've stocked up into the market, because at that time the supply will be really low, the prices will be really very high at that time. But when the speculators will come with their supply to the market, they will reduce this very high price in the market to a little bit lower level and make that product available to needy people at that time. So what is happening is that when the price are very low, speculators are slightly increasing those prices because of the demand, and when the prices in future are going to be very high, at that time, because they bring in the fresh supply into the market, they're going to reduce the prices. So by doing that, they are actually leveling off the prices from present and future. So they are kind of helping all of us. They're not responsible for this price rise. They are not at all responsible, because see, they are not responsible for, let's say, lack of rain. It's just a natural phenomena, and they are just responding to that. We all will respond to that. If we know that there is going to be a flood in future, suppose, you know, a dam releases water, a lot of water, and we all know that there is going to be, you know, a flood, and because of that all these essential items will kind of vanish from the market, we all will rush to market and try to stock up. So we all are going to hoard. But that doesn't mean that, you know, we are harming anyone. What we are doing is we are trying to protect our future, right? That's what these speculators are doing. And suppose if you say that if the speculators are kind of wrong, then if the speculators are wrong about the future, then they are going to make losses, and all these bad speculators who frequently make, you know, kind of wrong predictions about future, they are going to go bankrupt and they are going to go out of market. So most of the time what will happen in a marketplace, if we have a free market, all the efficient good speculators will be in the business, those who can see the uncertain future in a much better way than other people. So they will help the society. So speculative hoarders, they are not responsible for the price rise. As I said, mainly what is happening is the rupee, the currency note, is losing its purchasing power day by day. So that is what is resulting into this slowly rising prices. And whenever there is some kind of supply shock, a little bit like this monsoon or some other problem, let's say in Iraq we have problem right now, oil becomes scarce, the prices jump suddenly. So it's the supply side bottlenecks, you know, are not only responsible for price rise. It is also from the demand side. Actually, it is the supply of rupee, the currency note, that is rising, which is reducing the purchasing power of this currency note. And that's why it feels as if the prices of those commodities are going up. So it's not just the supply bottleneck. Main problem is that RBI's loose monetary policy. If they'll stop printing money, if they freeze the money supply wherever it is right now, this price rise will be, you know, kind of less enhanced. Or what will happen if we have complete free market over a long period of time, actually the prices will have a secular downward trend. They'll start to go up, because if money supply is stable, the production of goods and services is rising, because we have a free market economy, what will happen over a long period of time, the prices will start to go down. And that's real progress. Declining prices is real progress, right? Because then you don't have one lot of money. Just with your nominal income, its real income goes up, the purchasing power goes up, and you can buy more now. That's how you bring people out of poverty, and not by printing money. So government is, and again, you know why there are a lot of bottlenecks? Because again, government central planning, right? Not a single sector of Indian economy is kind of untouched by government central planning. They are meddling everywhere, whether that is agriculture sector, whether that is industrial sector, or whether there is service sector. All kinds of rules and regulations and acts are smothering all these, you know, areas, and all these bottlenecks have been created artificially by the government. And on the other side, though, when the government, Modi government, is blaming the speculative hoarders, they themselves are biggest speculative hoarders, right? Because we have this Food Corporation of India, which has huge stocks of all kinds of grains. Now, what happens if they are wrong, you know, about their forecast of future? They will not go out of business, right? No matter what happens, all these bureaucrats, they are going to be in business, because they don't have to own their money honestly. Right, from their customers, they just loot the taxpayer, and from that taxpayer's money, their salaries have been drawn. So no matter how much wrong government itself is, it is never going to go out of business. So that market check or profit and loss system is not functioning in the case of government itself. So the speculative hoarding, which is very wrong, we see that, you know, tons and tons of wheat decays every year in Food Corporation of India's, you know, warehouses. Nothing happens to them. They never go out of business. So nobody is blaming government. Government is not blaming themselves. They never blame themselves. They'll always blame us, common man, that we are responsible for price rise. As I say, it's the RBI who is responsible for this inflation, which is nothing but increasing the supply of money and credit. Okay, so this is one thing. Speculative hoarders are not responsible for price rise. What they do is they actually level off and they benefit the society, because what they do is that when there is real need of all these goods and services, they will provide them in the future, because they stock that up with them. Okay, so we should not blame speculative hoarders. We should put the blame on the government where it rests, because they are very responsible. Okay, second thing is this railway fare hike, and that has created a big brouhaha right now, and a lot of uproar is going on, and people are becoming disillusioned already with this Modi government. I was telling you that Modi has no magic wand, and now no one person can run the economy, no matter how hard they will try. Even if God arrives on earth, they will not be able to calculate economically. Central planning will always fail. So that is what has started to happening. So what is happening, and many of these Modi supporters are right now, you know, kind of trying to somehow justify this, you know, hiking the railway fare. Many are saying that, oh, he's going to increase the safety and he's going to provide services. Well, you know, there is nothing like that. If that was the case, then safety and services would have been increased long time ago. The same BJP government was in power for 10 years, right? And as I said, even if that's increasing a little bit, we can have a much better improvement if we have a completely privatized system of railways, and not only that, transportation overall, right? But anyways, let's not go into broken window fallacy and, you know, not go into doing counterfactual analysis. What I want to focus right now on is whether this railway fare hike is, you know, they hike the passenger fare by something like 14.2% and the freight by something like 6%. This is a big, huge, you know, price. First thing, Modi, you know, is himself is kind of hypocrite, because in 2012, when this UPA government increased railway fare hike, he himself was saying that this is unethical and not good for the economy, and this is going to hurt the common man. And now when he became the prime minister, he himself raised it by 14%. So that hypocrisy aside, let's talk about the economics of this thing. See, what reason they are giving is that they are saying that by hiking this, you know, a fare of railway, government railways, the Indian Railways is going to generate something like 5,000 crore rupees. And through that, they will provide different amenities, you know. The problem is that there is no need to increase government revenue, right? The problem is with this whole, you know, idea that somehow we need to increase government revenue. No, we don't need to increase government revenue. What we need to do is we need the government to stop spending money. Instead of, you know, trying to raise revenue, they should kind of rein in their spending, because this big bloated government and its different bureaucratic departments like Indian Railways, that is a problem to begin with. If we have free market competition in railways, prices will not go up. Prices will in fact go down, as I said, if we have stable money supply and competition in the railway market also, and among the other transport, you know, alternatives, then the prices will go up. Many people are thinking that this is good. But how can price rise be good? We don't want continuously rising prices. What we want is that all these, you know, private parties competing for this market, and in doing that, they reduce the prices of not only railways, but all other products. So somehow this whole idea that price rise and through revenue they're going to provide safety and services is absurd, you know. Safety and services can be provided by efficient management also. For that, you don't need to increase your revenue, right? The problem is with the public ownership of railways and mismanagement and inefficiency and everything in this bureaucracy. So government, we don't need a bigger government. We need to roll back the government, make it smaller and smaller. Governments should, you know, kind of decrease their spending and ultimately make it zero, right? They should stop intervening into the market. As long as government is running the railways, nothing better, nothing good is going to happen. So this whole logic of increasing revenue is kind of, it doesn't really make any sense. What they can do is that they can just get out of the market and allow the private players. And I'm not saying private players mean just Tatas and Ambanis and others. Anybody can, who is capable enough of, you know, financing all these businesses by going to the public into the stock market, they can start their private railway company, and they can compete and reduce the prices of rail fare and simultaneously provide better services, because in market you can only earn profit. Remember, this is market's rule. Entrepreneurs can earn profit only by providing and satisfying the most urgent needs of their consumers, and that they can do only by providing the best quality goods at the cheapest possible price. So if we really want the railways to do good, we have to remove the government monopoly from the railway. And once they're out, all the private players will get into picture, they'll compete with each other, and the prices will go down. So this railway fare hike, no way can be justified, right? No matter how much government is going to, you know, increase the revenue, it's always going to be into shortfall, because they'll keep on spending more than what they're earning. They're already bankrupt. Right, all these different measures of increasing revenue will fail ultimately. If they are going to increase tax rate, that is going to fail also. And as I said, ultimately, that is not the solution or the problem. Right, so I think what they should be doing is government, you know, Modi is, you know, as I said, he's not a magician, he's not a god, he's not a savior. He's going to follow the same kinds of policies as his predecessors. They can only, you know, have Keynesianism going on and this, you know, fascism going on here and there. They try to patch the things and never question the root of the problem, which is this big bloated government itself. And as long as we have the state with us, as long as we have this government and politicians and bureaucrats managing the economy, nothing good is going to come out of it. So I think this is it for this week. I just wanted to focus on these two issues. Next time I'll come back and discuss other things. You know, we have to see the situation in Iraq, what is going to happen with the oil prices. And in July, we are also going to have budget of Modi government. So let's see what they have to offer. I mean, I don't expect too much from it because, as I said, they will follow the same kind of policies. Anyway, you take care of yourself over there and I'll see you later on. Goodbye.